everyone, welcome back. Sorry it's been a while, I've been busy with college. Anyways, let's imagine a perfectly realistic scenario. Your survival Minecraft base has 80 floors. Okay, I'm not even gonna pretend like this makes sense. I don't know what kind of unhinged lunatic would set their base up in the layout of a corporate office building, but here we are, and you need to be able to access every single floor instantly. Luckily, we have a handy elevator. All you gotta do is walk up to the button panel, pick your desired floor, let's go with 6, 8. And then step into the elevator shaft and wait until your elevator arrives. Of course, there's also a down feature. All you gotta do is select the floor and then jump into the drop chute. Isaac Newton already made a pretty great downwards elevator, so no need to reinvent the wheel. Okay, so enough floundering. How does this work? Well, it's a relatively simple item selection system, connected to a somewhat complex demibolt-based item sorter, which is then hooked up to a piece of a rail cannon I stole from Cubic Meter. It's fun, this thing. Go check out Cubic's video, it's pretty cool. I also happen to be in it, which is pretty funny. Anyways, let's get into the finer details. I'm gonna start with the floor selection system. When you look inside of this chest and drop an item, it goes into this hopper that's concealed behind this trapdoor. This immediately enters this dropper chute, which sends it to this chest minecart at the bottom. We then use a piston bolt to run the chest minecart over a bunch of hoppers, where it will quickly sort the item that you put into it. Okay, so now here's the really interesting bit that makes this all work. The chest minecart takes time to get from the first floor hopper all the way to the 80th floor hopper, and it passes over each hopper once every 1/20th of a second, or a tick. At the exact same moment, a signal is passed up the tower and it hits each floor every game tick, meaning that when this chest minecart is on top of the 50th floor hopper, the signal is going to be at the 50th floor. Since these events are essentially synchronized, the moment that your chest minecart containing the query hits the hopper that you're looking for, we essentially freeze time and we go over to the signal somewhere inside of the tower. Look at what floor is at, and that is the floor that you've selected. Your floor selection is determined by this redstone block moving from the right to the left, which essentially just turns on the water, the catch for the drop chute, and the catch for the TNT, closing this trapdoor, which is what we'll talk about next. The state of you might have noticed that there's actually two explosions, and this is because we actually need one explosion for sending the TNT up to the player, and then another one to send the player to the destination. The mechanism that makes this all work is actually pretty clever. If I go ahead and query a floor, then I go ahead and freeze the game. The first TNT is gonna fly into this little holder, which triggers this tripwire hook and then extends this piston. The next TNT lands on top of the piston head, putting it slightly above the other TNT, which means that when this first TNT explodes, it's going to send the second TNT flying upwards. When you actually input the query, it causes the sticky piston here to extend its glass block, which is going to act as the stopper for this TNT. Then it's just going to land on the scaffold and get ready to be injected into the elevator shaft. Then the TNT gets launched by a slime block into the water underneath you, sending you to the moon. When you reach your destination, you're essentially caught by this trapdoor mechanism, but the old version had scaffolding that did this instead. You'd think that scaffolding would accomplish this task passively, but apparently the game doesn't like it when you're flying through a gazillion scaffolding at Mach 10. A convenient side effect of the trapdoors is that when they're not used to stop you or catch you, they actually block the exit, which prevents any unwanted horizontal adventures. Okay, on to other stuff. Unfortunately, this machine really only works in creative and peaceful mode, because otherwise you get basically atomized by the TNT. Also, building this in survival would be hell, considering all the stained glass that you'd have to rename for this. So that begs an important question. Why the hell would anyone build this? Well, I don't really know. Not something that I considered very deeply when I was designing it. But to me at least, maybe the real elevator was the signal pipe that we built into the back of the machine along the way. Also, I removed the 67th floor because when I showed it to my friends, It was all they requested. And the 13th, because that's like superstition or something. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. I have a Discord in the description. See you in another 3 months.